Hello children, today we will discuss about second chapter of class 6, our Karnataka. Karnataka is our state and Kannada is our language. It is important to know about the natural resources, agriculture, industries and other aspects of our land. For the administrative purpose, Karnataka is divided into four revenue divisions. They are Bengaluru division, 9 districts, Mysuru division, 8 districts, Belagavi division, 7 districts, Kalburgi division, 6 districts. All together, how many districts children? All together, there are 30 districts. Each district is headed by a deputy commissioner and the division is headed by a divisional commissioner. Now let us learn about Bengaluru division. Dear children, which is the capital of Karnataka? Bengaluru is the capital of Karnataka. There are 9 districts in Bengaluru division. Bengaluru urban, Bengaluru rural, Kolar, Chikkaballapura, Ramanagara, Tumkuru, Chitradurga, Shivamogga, Davanagere. This division is in the southern part of Karnataka. History of Bengaluru division. Bengaluru has a history as rich as Karnataka. The earliest rulers were from the Ganga dynasty. Kualalapura was their capital, that is present Kolar. After the decline of the Gangas, the area came under the rule of Cholas, Vaisalas, Vijayanagara kings, Marathas, Mysuru kings and Bijapur Adil Shahis. During the rule of Vijayanagara Empire, Palegara were appointed to administer different regions. These regions were called Palepattu. Palegaras were the leaders reported to the Vijayanagara kings. They had to submit tax and gifts to the king. Some of the important Palepattus were Keladi, Chitradurga, Yelahanka, and Chikkaballapura. Now next move on to the natural resources. Dear children, resources obtained from nature are called as natural resources. For example, rivers, waterfalls, animals, soil, minerals, etc. The climate of all the district is not similar. Kolar has a hot climate and Shivamogga district gets highest rainfall, but Chitradurga receives lowest rainfall. Remaining districts receive moderate rainfall. Many of the rivers in Bengaluru division originates in the Western Ghats. Western Ghats, which means a low mountain range in West India. It is also known as Sahyadri. Some of the rivers are Uttara Pinakini, Dakshina Pinakini, Vedavati, Shimsha, Tungabhadra, Sharavati, Varada and others. World famous Jog Falls is in Shivamogga district. Waterfalls named Muthyalamadu is in Bengaluru division. Gajanuru and Tunga dams are in Shivamogga districts. Mysuru kings have constructed many dams. Many of our rivers have dried out due to environmental pollution. Deforestation. Deforestation is the large-scale removal of trees in the forest and uncontrolled urbanization and many other reasons. As a result, severe scarcity of water is there. There is an urgent need to protect the water resource like tanks and save underground water. This division has many mineral deposits. The most productive gold mines of the country are in Karnataka. And Kolar gold mine is famous among all. But the gold deposits of this mine is completely used up. Iron ore deposits are found in Chitradurga and Tumkuru districts. Now we will go to the next topic, that is forest, wild animals and national parks. Forest. Shivamogga has a dense forest cover. You know very well, I have told you that
Shivamogga district gets highest rainfall, so it is covered by dense forest, which means thick forest. The forest cover of Bengaluru urban district is the least. Because of the growth of cities and industries, the district of this division have forests ranging from evergreen forest to deciduous forest. An evergreen forest is a forest which remains green throughout the year. The Sahyadri mountain range passes on the borders of Shivamogga district. These forests have bamboo, banyan, tamarind, sandalwood, dindiga, teak, jali, mango and neem trees. The tallest mountain in Bengaluru division is Halu Rameshwara Gudda in Chitradurga district. This division has many wild animals: wild cat, tiger, leopard, bison, wild pig, deer, bear and wolf are some of the important wild animals. Now let us know about wildlife sanctuaries and national parks and forest reserves. For the protection of the forest and animals, many forest reserves, wildlife sanctuaries and national parks have been set up. Some of these are Jogimatti Forest Reserve in Chitradurga, Bannerghatta National Park in Bengaluru, Bhadra Wildlife Sanctuary, Sharavati Wildlife Sanctuary, Shettihalli Wildlife Sanctuary, Gudavi Bird Sanctuary in Shivamogga, Vulture Sanctuary in Ramnagara, Mandagade Bird Sanctuary in Shivamogga. Children, do you want to see wild animals like tiger, bear, elephant, deer and other animals in the forest? If so, do visit the wildlife sanctuaries and bird sanctuaries present in your division and enjoy seeing those wild animals in their natural environment.
Dear children, now let us study about agriculture and growth of industries. Agriculture is the main occupation of people in Bengaluru division. The agricultural activity is rain dependent. Shivamogga district is well irrigated because Shivamogga district gets highest rainfall in Bengaluru division. The main crops of this division are ragi, maize, paddy, groundnuts and various pulses, coconut, arecanut, cotton, sugarcane and others. Mulberry, which is the backbone of silk industry. Mulberry forms the basic food material for silkworms. It is cultivated in Bengaluru and Ramnagara district. Ragi and rice are the major staple food crops of this division. Roti is made of ragi and rice are consumed more. Sweet like payasa, holige, kichadi, shavige are consumed during. Children, now you can see the picture of Sir M. Vishveshwaraya. He is the founder of state's industrial sector. He received India's highest honor, the Bharat Ratna, in 1955. He implemented the forethought of Krishnaraja Vadayar IV. If we don't establish industries now, we cannot attain progress. Big industries have been established in places like Bengaluru, Bhadravati, Tumkuru, Shivamogga and other places. Bengaluru is the most important industrial place in India. There is an iron and steel industry in Bhadravati of Shivamogga district. It was established in the year 1923. It is now called as Vishveshwaraya Iron and Steel Industries Limited. The first cement factory of the state was established in Bhadravati. Karnataka is ranked second in the export of garments in India. Exports are goods and services that are produced in one country and sold to buyers in another country. The government has established apparel parks in cities like Doddaballapur, Anekal to promote the production of ready-made garments. Now let us study about the contributions of Bengaluru division in the field of art, literature, folklore, theatre and dance. Now let us study contributions of writers in the field of literature. The three important writers who received the highest award, which is called Jnanapita Award in Kannada literature, Kuvempu, Masi Venkatesh Iyengar and U.R. Anantamurthy. They belongs to the Bengaluru division. This is an indication of the literary achievements of Bengaluru division. Let us see about the contributions in the field of ancient literature.
12th century in the Indian history very famous because during that time vachana literature has developed. The most famous vachanakaras of 12th century who belongs to the Bengaluru division are Akkamahadevi and Allama Prabhu. They are from Balligave of Shivamogga district in Bengaluru division. The famous dasas who belongs to Bengaluru division are Sri Padarayaru and Purandara Dasaru. Next, let us see the contributions of writers in the field of literature in the modern period. They are Kuvempu, D.V. Gundappa, Masi Venkatesh Iyengar, Nisar Ahmad, Anantamurthy, Lankesh, Anupama Niranjana, M.K. Indira, Na D'Souza, Dodda Rangegowda, etc. Next one is contributions in the field of theatre. The most famous personalities who contributed in the field of theatre are Gubbi Veeranna, Subbaiya Naidu, K. Hiranaya, Master Hiranaya, etc. Subbaiya Naidu was a hero of the first Kannada talkie movie Sati Sulochana. Srimati Maya Rao, who contributed immensely in the field of dance. Now let us study the contributions in the field of cinema. The film industry is growing positively due to the contributions from personalities like Dr. Rajkumar, Dr. Vishnuvardhan, Shankar Nag, Maya Rao, etc. Next, let us learn folklore of Bengaluru division. The famous folklore expert and writer Dr. H.L. Nagegowda has established a folklore center Janapada Loka in Ramnagara district. It is a wonderful folklore museum. The famous folk arts of Bengaluru division are Karaga festival, Somana Kunita, Mudalapaya, Yakshagana, Garudi Kunita, Dullu Kunita, Kamsale Kunita. These are the best examples for folk arts which are there in the Bengaluru division. That's all for today, children. Thank you.